Kano Model also helps us in prioritizing the requirement by way of categorizing them. The first category used in the Kano Model is called dissatisfier. It is also known as a threshold. These are the type of requirements. If they are not present in our product, our user will be dissatisfied. If these requirements are present in the product, it will not increase the satisfaction because they are expecting these requirements as a threshold requirement. Then we have a second kind of requirement, which is called satisfier requirement. If we put these functionality capability in our product, user will be satisfied. The more we implement them, the more satisfaction of the users will increase. Then we have a delighter, sometimes also known as exciter. These are those kind of requirements. If we implement them, users will be delighted because they are not expecting those things in those kind of product. If we do it, it will create an excitement in our user base. Then there could be a fourth category, which is called indifferent. If we put those kind of capability in our product, most of the user may be indifferent about those functionalities.